An informal database of all informal settlements that is citywide and regularly updated is important for many reasons. In every city, it forms the basis for planning development interventions and is invaluable in times of disaster and crisis. Such a database, if it does not exist, can be created by the city or informal community networks or NGOs with a view to involving the city and communities in the process. However, cities rarely have a complete, up-to-date list of slums or informal settlements. It could be that they do not want to acknowledge their presence, or it is just a process that is not part of their routine activity. Developing a profile of a slum is an important building block for undertaking a city-wide listing of slums and collecting information about them. It develops a more strategic form if it is taken up by the residents of the informal settlements themselves. By producing this information, the residents develop a profile of their settlement, announce its name and its characteristics. This is what a settlement survey does. NSDF and Mahila Milan, who create organizations of informal settlements in cities in India, have successfully conducted such surveys and information gathering in several cities and shared it with the city. The first step is to find out what already exists. Who in the municipality already has some information, or if community organizations or NGOs already have a partial list. Often cities or researchers have studied land records of slums or counted them in the past. More recently, there may be city development plans, CDPs, or other development plans or census data. Data collected and confirmed by residents of slums or informal neighborhoods is ideal. It provides details of its history, and by owning the data, communities take the first step in exploring communication on the basis of the data. Such a process has to start with meetings at the informal settlement or slum level to introduce the community to the potential and possibilities of collecting information about themselves to prepare a settlement profile. Asking about land ownership, political domination, and history of residential or commercial establishments helps residents reflect on their situation. It helps trigger the possibility of collating what the residents know about themselves into a collective representation of information. Even when a sample questionnaire is available, a format evolves almost automatically through group discussions. A reflection on what is known about the settlement almost automatically leads to discussions about what they can do with this information collectively, for their internal understanding of what they can do together, or to make a representation to the city officials, local politicians, or to compare their settlement with others like them. Once the format of the survey is finalized, volunteers representing different groups, young, old, men and women, agree to work together, and the informal collection of information begins.
तभी आपका अनुभव है, वो उनके साथ में आप काम करेंगे, मदद करेंगे उनको। आपका समझ में आया पूरा? Okay?
People investigate many things. How old the settlement is, how many units or structures, their condition, their location in relation to amenities like schools, hospital, post office, transport, etc. Understanding internal amenities and services such as water, sanitation, roads, electricity, community centers, open spaces, and local leadership and organization within communities. Once the profile is ready, the volunteers share their findings with the community so everyone feels comfortable about the data generated. After that, many possibilities can emerge. They can support other settlements to collect data, becoming mentors and guides to others. They can form a group to seek an appointment with the city. They can decide to have discussions with local schools, hospitals, or any other facility providing agency about how they can use their services, etc. Whether you are an external interventionist or a community leader assisting others, remember that slum profiles must produce engagement. Later, when there is a need to create a household database, or if this data is needed by cities, individual household surveys can be undertaken with ease and familiarity by the residents' associations themselves.